Alors, M. Peter Krentz, qui veut parler de piste cyclable, il veut s'adresser au maire de Montréal. Bienvenue, M. Krentz. Vous savez comment est-ce qu'on fonctionne? Un petit préambule, et ensuite de ça, vous posez votre question. Welcome aboard.
Ça fait... it's been many times I've even asked you questions, M. Lavallée. And now we're at the mayor. Same old question. Bixie's a great program, blah, blah, blah. You have a plaque in front. I came with my bicycle. Where do I park my bicycle? There's no biking parks, except over there in the corner. Sort of like second-class citizens. The bike path downtown, it's nice. It's successful in a sense, but it's a disaster as far as safety goes. The city of Montreal doesn't have any safety plans or knowledge of safety. The bike path being built on University Street, there's construction there and there's cars parked in it. If you're coming down University the wrong way on the bike path, where do you go? Into the traffic. These are the problems that the city of Montreal doesn't take care of, but everything's good for the Bixies. Even the Bixie bikes, well, they're very heavy, 21 kilos or 44 pounds, and also unstable. Very interesting. Try and ride the bicycle with your handles off it, without holding on the handlebars. It's impossible because it's unstable. So the Bixie program also copied my bike rack, the one I presented to the city, the concept in the front. Very interesting. And I'm still being ignored by the city. And I have a letter here in front of me, addressed to Gérald Tremblay, Ministère d'Industrie et Technologie. Remember that letter, Mr. Tremblay? Yes.
So, Mr. Krentz, please ask your question, please.
The question is simple. What has been done for cyclist safety in Montreal?
Alors, la question est posée. En réponse, Madame Barbe.
Merci, M. le Président. Merci, M. Krentz, pour votre question. Je peux vous parler en français parce que je connais que votre français est excellent. On s'est déjà parlé à plusieurs reprises. Vous permettez que je vous réponde en français? Monsieur, ça va? Si je vous réponds en français?
No, I'd rather hear it in English.
In English?
Yes. Sure.
So, in terms of...
en fait, vous répondez dans la langue que vous voulez. Là.
Oui. Alors, en termes de sécurité, M. Krentz, je dois vous dire que nos... pistes cyclables, nos voies cyclables, on doit dire les voies cyclables parce qu'il y a des tronçons qui sont hors piste, il y a des tronçons qui sont en bande cyclable, donc une piste cyclable, c'est la connotation hors piste, hors rue plutôt. Donc, nos voies cyclables sont designées par nos services en appui avec Vélo Québec. Alors, nous considérons en bonne... nous avons toute raison de croire que nos voies cyclables que nous construisons sont... sont tout à fait sécuritaires pour les utilisateurs cyclistes. Alors, et je peux juste réaffirmer dans le cadre du budget, donc c'est un conseil spécial aujourd'hui qui porte sur le budget, 2010, la Ville de Montréal va continuer à faire ses efforts importants et c'est 7,5 millions de dollars que nous allons investir en 2010 pour construire 45 nouveaux kilomètres de pistes, de voies cyclables, je devrais dire. Alors, je dois vous dire que, M. Krentz, malgré ce que vous pensez ou ce que vous dites, ce que vous affirmez, les utilisateurs en général de nos voies cyclables à Montréal sont très, très heureux. D'ailleurs, je vous rappelle que nous avons gagné un prix à Copenhague pour nos efforts en investissement en transport actif et collectif.
Merci beaucoup, Mme Barbe. So, Mr. Krentz, if you have another question, ask your question directly.
Like Manon Bart said, I had contact with her previously, and that was back in the days, I don't know exactly the date, but what was really interesting is she was in charge of building a small little bridge right beside the Verdun Yacht Club. And today, that bridge exists, and it costed about $130,000, and it's not really part of the cycling path because everyone rides around it, because the bridge was so badly designed, it's even hard to walk up on it. And then the city of Verdun had to add a little adjustment to it to make it rideable for bicycles. So I encountered your design capabilities and everything like that. Just go and see that bridge, $130,000. It's a lousy bridge for cyclists. It doesn't work. How can it be safe? And you're telling me you're designing bicycle paths with Vélo Québec when I see a bridge like that?
The question is asked.
How can you say you're designing safe bicycle paths if the bridge there doesn't even function for cyclists?
You made your comments. You asked your question. Mr. Tassi. Mr. Tassi.
Mr. President, thank you, Mr. Krantz, for your question. I personally cycle on that bridge, I don't know, many hundreds of times, without any difficulty. The bridge was built with a subsidy from Hydro-Québec. Unfortunately, I don't know the exact cost of the bridge, but we can look into it, but I doubt that it's $130,000. The main purpose of the bridge is to able the cars and trucks that goes with the boats, for the boats to go in the water. It's right beside the marina. There was a cycling path going around the restaurant, the Crescendo restaurant, but it's more direct to go through the bridge. I just can repeat that I don't understand your point, because I personally cycle there many, many times. I'd say 5-6 times a week, every week during the season. So and I've never seen any problems. My children do so also.
Merci beaucoup, M. Tassé. Merci. Thank you, M. Krantz. On continue.